When you were little, did you ever have dreams that felt so real you believed they were true? You probably did. But did any of them really happen? One did to me. A couple of months ago, someone sent me a letter. Someone I thought wasn't real. It all started 2 years ago, in October of '88.
Sophia! Where are you?
I had promised to go camping with my sister Sophia and her friends near Baker's Hill. We'd been there many times when we were younger, but this was the first time since I moved back.
Stay there. I'll find a way over.
I woke up in the middle of the night and found my sister's tent empty.
One step at a time. You can do this. Calm and easy.
The night before, Sis and her friends sat around the dying fire late into the night, talking and giggling. It had been tough for her, me moving back and everything. But to run off like this wasn't like her. I just hoped she wouldn't hurt herself.
It really stinks in here.
Thank you.
all these people went missing here? I knew she wasn't herself when I reached the other side of that broken bridge. She would have waited for me.
Hey, anyone in there?
did they run off to? A few days later, the young girl was found wandering around the forest, mumbling. I'm not sure what happened to the guy she was with. I know people went out looking for him, thinking he had done something to her. He somehow got away. I think it's missing a piece. You're probably wondering why I squeezed through that tight crevice. But at the time, I just needed to get to my sister quickly. I realized that I've been looking for my sister for some time. For that funny, carefree girl who was always so sweet.
I think a piece is missing. I think a piece is missing. I think a piece is missing. I think a piece is missing.
Wow.
I think a piece is missing.